This video is about creating videos using Stream, which is a part of Microsoft 365. Using it, you can record screen, record yourself, edit it, trim it, add some music, publish it, and share it. No other special software is required. So let's see how this is done. First is, where is Stream? So go to Office 365, office.com, login. Go to these 9 dots, look at explore all your apps, and you will see Stream. When you go to Stream, there are 3 things you can do. Upload videos which you already have, record them and edit them, and create a playlist. So we are going to focus on the recording part. As soon as I go to record, this runs completely on browser. So first time you are doing it, it may ask you for some kind of permission to access camera and microphone. Now look at what it allows me to do. Record either video or audio. I can also record screen. And if it is video, I have an additional option called backdrop. But before that, I'm going to switch off the video audio right now and understand the options first. Of course, you should choose the best available camera and the best available mic. There is a very interesting feature called teleprompter, which allows you to put your script, which I've already pasted here. You should reduce the font size. By default, it scrolls very slowly. So pause it again. Go to the scroll speed option. 100 is the default. 50 is minimum, 400 is maximum. I'm going to keep it at 400 and try it out. So try to read a line. Say, working on Word, you will see a diamond icon. So by the time I finish a line, the next line should appear. That's the correct speed. I want the screen to be recorded. And while recording the screen, I'm going to show, teach a new feature in Word. So come back to Stream. What I want is record screen and record my face on top of it. Now the problem is, when I say record screen, it goes into record screen mode, allows me to select a screen like we do in sharing of screens during a meeting. I'm not going to choose entire screen, I'll choose a window, and this is the Word document window. The moment I say share, what happens? Something beeps. This is actually starting to record my screen, and I don't want that. I want my face also to be recorded. So I'm just going to stop recording. I'm confused now. I'm just going to go back, say delete and start over. That's not what I wanted. If I click on video, it's just going to record my video. It's not going to record that screen. I want both. And that option is in the third one called backdrop. Why? Because I want that Word screen to be the backdrop. So go to backdrop. It does have the standard things like blur, green screen, video background or static background. I can even upload my own picture or videos. But the most important button here is this. So now click on that button. Again, it'll ask you what do you want to share. And this time I'm going to choose the same Word window. And now it does not start recording. I come back. The backdrop thing is still on. I just close it because I've already chosen the correct option. Now I can see myself on the screen. Now, before I do the actual demo, I'm going to show some kind of introduction. Now, that introduction has a script. So I'm going to open the teleprompter. And now, when I click record, this will start playing the teleprompter. I'm adjusting the teleprompter in such a way that it's right in front of me so that it looks as though I'm looking at the camera, but actually I'm looking at the teleprompter text. So let's get started. Now, the browser version of Word has recently added a new feature called Suggested Images. Click on it to see suggested images and choose the one you like. These images come from the stock art collection, which is a part of Microsoft 365. Now the introduction is done. I'm going to close this. And now I want the screen to be visible. I don't want my photo to be such big, occupying so much space. So this is the idea. Move presenter to right, middle and left. So I'm going to choose right. Now I move to the window and which contains Word, and let me show you the Word feature now. This is the real recording of the Word feature. If you see a diamond while you're writing something in Word on browser, click on it. It looks at the Word and suggests some relevant images. It's a nice image for a perspective. I'm going to choose that. Don't go searching for this feature. Probably this is under test, so I also get it sometimes, not always. Anyway, the training part educational content is done. Now I have to stop the recording, so I'll come back. The recording is still on, and by the time I come back and stop recording, some extra stuff will get recorded. So let me stop it and then see what happens next. Now recording is finished. If I want, I can add more recording, but right now I'm saying review. The browser version starts talking. I've reduced the volume to avoid confusion, but I know that this whole take I don't want. The end part I want to cut off. So click on it and trim the unwanted portion using this handle. Okay, so now trim is perfect. I'm going to say confirm. I can go to any part of the recording and say split. Now it becomes two clips. When I click on any clip, I can trim it independent of each other. Again, say confirm. And now I can rearrange them as well. Once I'm happy with it, I can even add music. So I'm going to just click on the plus sign, add music. You can play and try it out. But right now for demo, I'm just going to choose this. The audio volume is automatically adjusted so that it doesn't overpower your speech. If you want, you can adjust the music volume from here. To come out of this, do not click on this cross, click on this cross. Okay, so now play one more time. Make sure it is okay and click on finish. Why is it important? Because once you click on finish, you can't come back and edit. This edit is a one-time kind of edit. Now it generates the video, uploads it to stream, and allows you a choice of downloading it as well. Notice that the format is WebM, which is Web Multimedia, which is the preferred format. Traditionally, we use MP4, but WebM is better than that. So if you really want MP4, download it and use a third-party tool to convert it to MP4 or any other format. Now let's come back to this video. First, I'm going to rename it Word AI Illustrations. Now, the other thing is video settings. If you want, you can give a thumbnail like YouTube. It's a good idea. Then, most important, transcript, because educational videos can be long. And even if I have undergone the video, if I want to look for a specific topic, I still have to fast forward rewind. So this is capable of generating the transcript automatically. Very important, this generate button has to be clicked manually after upload and you choose the correct language. Of course, I spoke in English, but in English, there are multiple accents available. So choose the correct one. And also notice that there are many other languages supported. I'm going to choose English India and leave it alone. It'll tell you how long it'll take to generate. Typically, almost the same time as the duration of the video. Now the transcription is complete. So when I come back, I can click on the transcript and I see a separate pane showing the actual transcript. Now, of course, in long videos, nobody's going to read these, but I want to look for a specific phrase or topic. And that's very useful. I can search on the transcript. Notice the video is not playing. We are at the beginning. I'm going to search for the word perspectives. The moment I press enter, it actually highlights the exact point in time when the word perspective was spoken. Now notice what happens when I click on the word perspective. It doesn't just start from that word. It'll start few seconds before so that I have the context. It looks at the word and suggests some relevant images. It's a nice image for a perspective. It makes the same videos more useful because you can search on text based on spoken words. While we are at it, we can also have chapters for long videos. If you switch it on, you can add and edit chapters and then go to them. You want to allow people to or add comments on it. And of course, if you are publishing videos, you want to see how many people saw it. So analytics should generally be on. If this was done in a noisy environment, you can enable noise suppression. So that's about it. Once the video is done, of course, you want to share it with other people. Share button, click on the share dialog. And this is the familiar dialog we have seen in hundreds of places. You already know how to use this. There are two constraints. One, the duration of recording can be 15 minutes. And now, let's look at some additional features which are useful while you are creating and recording the content. As you can see, the recording is already on. What else can I do on top of this? So look at this toolbar. This is the annotation toolbar. So simple text. We have some nice templates here and I just type the text. Similarly, I can choose a color and use it for annotation purpose. Third thing is stickers. I have a large collection of stickers and I can use them to spice up my content. Like Instagram, we have filters. So you can choose a filter depending on what you are trying to do. To get rid of the filter, just click on this button. One feature which I like is a frame, decorate boring content. The other option which is useful is you want to do some annotation, but I don't want to just do it on top of whatever is the screen. I want sort of a notepad. So we have something called a board here. I have different types of boards and notepads. So I'll choose this and I can decide how much of space this occupies. And now I can position myself somewhere else and use this part for annotation, equations, explaining formulas. And finally, you can upload photos and position them wherever you want. Now we have seen the entire life cycle of setting up, recording, annotation, editing, music, final publishing, refining the settings of the video, and sharing it with others. I'm sure you found this useful. I'm also sure you desperately want to try it out and check whether you have this feature. So do it now and let me know if you like it. So that's it for now. Thank you.